So when I think about answering Rachel Parent, who's the activist child, who she's, well, young woman, who's running the website Kids Right to Know, Rachel was very vocal about her interest in labeling and her response to genetic modification of food. The things I just adore about Rachel is that she's clearly very articulate, clearly intelligent. She is excited about becoming engaged and in taking on a really important issue. And for that, I give her high marks. The problem that I have is when Rachel starts to let non-scientific thinking really kind of cloud her final decision-making process. I think that a little bit of critical overlays to what she's already started to understand would really help guide her further decisions in a scientific approach to this question. A good example might be that she sticks by all of the talking points, the, well, there are no higher yields, or when I'm referring to the video from O'Leary, that there are no higher yields, that there is no testing except by the companies themselves, that just a lack of real scientific thinking in terms of these particular issues. She says that they haven't been safety tested, that there's not, nothing has been proven safe, which as scientists we can tell you that we just can show you there's no evidence of harm. She also seems to take a very hard line that's when she says against all modifications, that she really doesn't want this technology being employed at all, later softens that in her interview. The one thing that Rachel continually comes back to is this idea of informed decisions. Informed decisions and right to know. And I always like to say that I'm with you. I'm with you on informed decisions, but you have to make sure that you have good information, not what you're being told by activist websites or other people with interests in ending biotechnology. What I'd really like to see, and what I always advocate, is with a right to know comes an obligation to learn. That you have to talk to scientists. You have to study the literature. And at 13 years old, that's pretty daunting. There's people who are graduate students who can't approach this literature very effectively. So what I would encourage you to do is to reach out to independent scientists like me or other scientists here on GMO Answers that can help give you some guidance that you don't have to accept, but you should test and you should compare against what other people are saying. Compare it to what the activists tell you. I think that all of the information together needs to be considered when we really want to make informed decisions. Most of all, I really would encourage Rachel and other young women like her to actively get involved in STEM disciplines, so science, technology, engineering, and math. That when someone is a passionate, someone who's willing to engage, someone who obviously can have great communications ability like her, would be equipped with the firepower of critical thinking and a good basis in science, she'd be unstoppable.